We cannot prevent climate change just by electric cars and wind power. The problem is far more complicated. Factors often forgotten in the discussions are population, population growth, energy consumption, and how we are producing the energy. Then our consumption behavior as human beings, what we buy, how much we buy, and so on. And then, of course, political decisions. Money is involved very much. Huge investments are needed. And then metals. Metals really do matter. And I try to open it today a little bit more. Why do they matter? But let's face first the root cause for the climate change. The world population growth, we are so many here. And when looking from the geological perspective, we can see how explosive growth this population growth has been. We haven't got the time to adjust and adapt to this kind of huge amount of one species alone in the planet. The more people, the more food, the more energy is needed, and all kinds of consumables. We are consumers. And then the middle class is growing. It's one part of the purchasing behavior, purchasing power. People want a high standard of living. They want smartphones, they want cars, they want all kinds of electrical appliances. And all this, producing all this and using them requires energy. So energy consumption grows. And how we produce this growing need of energy? The energy produced today is based on non-renewables mostly. There's a small slice for renewable energy sources at the moment, although there's abundant resources available, solar power, wind power. But to make a significant change in this requires enormous investments in new power plants. And here we come to the metals. In the past, we managed with just a handful of metals, copper with its alloying elements, zinc and tin, and iron and steel. But today, the new technology requires a lot more metals. And firstly, a lot more different metals. Not only the same metals, but the high technology applications, they need different metals with their unique characteristics. And unfortunately, many of these new metals are critical. Their resources are limited, or they are located in only few places on this planet. And the other side of the metals, why they matter so much, is that the new technology, electric cars, for example, they need much more tons or kilograms of those metals compared to conventional cars. And then the production of energy, the new renewable energy sources utilization with the new technology requires huge amounts of metals. So the whole equation is not just electric cars and wind power. It's so much more complex. When we are more in this planet, we require consumables, food, different appliances, and all this requires more energy. And it should be clean energy. That requires more metals, which requires more energy, which should be clean. And that requires more metals. So the vicious circles goes on, and the end result is that we have to ask, do we have all the metals needed? Or where do we get all those metals? At the moment, the production capacity of known mineral resources is not enough to cover the forecasted demand for these different metals. Recycling is said that it will solve the situation or the problem, but currently it's not running in full capacity. There's so much to be improved. And on the other hand, the forecasted demand grows so quickly, so strongly that recycling cannot fulfill the demand. It's part of the solution, but much more is needed. What can we do? In Aalto University, we are studying how we can get more out of depleting resources. So more out of less. And the other part is that when the metallic appliances are coming to the end of their life, they have to be recycled back to the production to get the metals recovered. So circular economy of metals is one focus area now. And last but not least, how to produce all those metals without producing carbon dioxide emissions. Just metals do matter very much. Solving the climate change problem requires metals. So producing metals, metals processing, metallurgy, that is a work that has a meaning. If you are interested, join us in Aalto University, our sustainable metals processing major, and start preventing the climate change. Thank you for listening.